So once we have done with the all the things like motherboard is installed, CPU is installed, your task is to close the case and connect the peripherals. So get the rest of PC components like monitor, keyboard, mouse, speakers. Connect VGA cable with VGA connector or VGA port. Connect your mouse or even a USB with PS2 port or with a USB port. Connect the speaker cable in the audio port. Plug in the power cable from PSU into UPS. Also plug in the power cable of monitor. Now double check all the cables before power on the PC. So now it's your responsibility to double check all the cables before you are going to power on your PC. You have successfully assembled a computer. Turn your computer on and prepare for operating system installations. Now your computer is properly installed. Now switch it on and wait for operating system to install. Next topic is motherboard and its types. Motherboard, it is the physical arrangement in computer that contains the computer basics, Shakti and components. So motherboard is one of the physical arrangement in the computer that we have all the components that help to run the computer system. In motherboard, we have a CPU, we have a heat sink, we have a fan, we have a CMOS battery, CMOS cell, RAM chip, we have a hard drive. So we have lots of components on a CPU, and this is called physical arrangement. Components are microprocessors, coprocessors, it is optional, not compulsory. Some of the motherboard have coprocessors, some of the motherboard don't have. We have a memory, BIOS means basic input output system. We have some expansion slots and interconnecting circuitry. This is the diagram of motherboard. These are the various components of motherboard. We have a different types of motherboards. Some of our traditional one and some of our modern one. So the some of the features or components that are present in traditional one does not compulsory that all these components are again present in the traditional one. So modern one. So traditional motherboard is little bit different from modern motherboards. See, this is called a CPU socket. This is mounting points, ATX power point. These blue line is called DRM slots, dynamic random access memory slot. It means they are memory slots. This black one is IDE, integrated development environment. And this is North Bridge. This is AGP slots, graphic slot, advanced graphic slot. This black one is called South Bridge. And these white ones, PCI slots, peripheral connectors. And this is called CMOS backup battery, complementary metal oxide semiconductor. These are various connectors. We can attach a microphone, speakers, and these are used to connect Ethernet, LAN. These are for our VGA cables. This is keyboard connector. This is mouse connector. We have seen in yesterday lab class. These are the connectors, keyboard connectors, mouse connectors, LAN connectors, USB connectors. So these are the various connectors. So this is the diagram. This is the these are the components of motherboard. We have PCI slots, South Bridge, North Bridge, AGP slots, IDE, DRAM slots, dynamic memory slots, ATX power, mounting points, CPU socket. These are the peripherals, means input output devices connectors. We can attach pen drives, keyboard, mouse, LAN cables, and this is cell, CMOS cell. Types of motherboard based on the form factors. Form factor ATX. ATX stands for Advanced Technology Standard. We have a micro ATX, mini ITX, nano ITX, or pico ITX. These are some of the factors on the basis of these factors, we have to choose a motherboard. First is ATX, Advanced Technology Extended. ATX means Advanced Technology Extended. ATX is a motherboard specification that define board's physical dimensions like connectors placement, I/O ports, supported power supplies, and it is introduced by Intel in 1995, and it was designed to replace the previous AT. That was the standard for desktop PC. Now it's ATX. It means ATX replace AT. AT means Advanced Technology. ATX means Advanced Technology Extended. Most important improvements and benefits of ATX are, it improved the reliability as compared to AT, because AT was designed for desktop PC and ATX is designed to overcome the limitations of AT. It support modern input-output standards like USB. It support graphics. It support large expansion slots, and its cost is less. Full-size ATX motherboard is 12 inches wide and 9.6 inch deep. It means it is 305 into 244 mm. This is the size of this type of motherboards, ATX motherboards, Advanced Technology Extended motherboards. Standard ATX look like this: Micro ATX, Mini ITX, Nano ITX, or Pico ITX. These are the types of motherboards. Next is micro. Micro means smaller in a size. Sometimes it is called MATX or Micro ATX. It is the motherboard that is 9.6 wide into 9.6 deep. And it is capable of being as small as 6.75 wide and 6.75 deep. So it means it works like a ATX, but it is only smaller in size because it's Advanced Technology Extended. So it just work like a normal ATX. But the thing is that it is smaller in size only. When should you buy a micro ATX motherboard? Now there is one question: when I have to buy micro instead of to buy the ATX? You are going after the cheapest. When you want to buy some cheapest motherboard, then we have to go for this. You want a computer that good enough for most purpose. So when I have some criteria in my mind, I want to purchase a motherboard that is cheap, but it's also a micro ATX, Advanced Technology Extended, but it is micro, smaller in size, so it may be a less cheap. Mini, it consume less power and it is 6.7 into 6.7 inches. Again, it is ITX. It's a mini ITX, not a mini ATX. It's mini ITX. It consume less power, and it is of 6.7 into 6.7 inches. Nano, again, more smaller. It is another type of ITX, 4 into 7. It is only designed for those computers that require less power supply. Pico, most smallest. That is of 3.9 into 2.0, and it is 75% smaller than mini. 75% smaller than this mini. This Pico is 75% smaller than this mini ITX. Now see the comparison of motherboard form factor. Standard ATX designed by Intel 1995, dimensions 12 into 13 inches. Micro ATX, again developed by Intel in 1997, dimensions are 9.6 into 9.6. Mini ITX, MIA 2001, 6 into 7. Nano ITX designed by YAI in 2003, and it is its dimensions are 4 into 7 into 4 into 7 inches. Next, Pico, more smaller, and this Pico is 75% smaller than this mini. YAI is the company or a manufacturer who designed this motherboard, and it is developed in 2007, and its dimensions are 3.9 into 2.8 inches. This is the comparison of different motherboard form factors. Now types on motherboard based on the use. Desktop motherboard is different, laptop motherboard is different, and server motherboard is completely different. Now we have to choose the motherboard depend upon our use. If I'm using desktop, I have to select the motherboard that is for desktop. If I'm using laptop, I have to select the motherboard for laptop. And if I'm working on a server, or if my computer is served as a server, it means it getting the request from client, processing the request and send the result back to the client, then I have to choose the server motherboard. Now its selection is depend upon your use. See, this is the desktop motherboard. It is used in personal computers or it is used in desktop. It is used for applications like home, office, and it's a very basic type of motherboard. So this is for desktop computers. That computer you are using in home or office only, and it is very basic type of motherboard. Laptop motherboard. Laptop motherboard connect different parts of the laptop system. It have some advanced features as compared to desktop motherboard. It looks like this. Server motherboard, it is more advanced as compared to desktop and the laptop, and it provide high-end services. It means it is always available 24/7 environment, so more powerful as compared to other motherboards. It looks like this. CPU chip, we have some CMOS cell, north bridge, south bridge, various components of motherboard. Motherboard manufacturers, motherboard.com web address is this. Dell, www.dell.com, IBM. It means these are the motherboard manufacturers, and this is their address, web address. Iwill Corporation, www.iwill.net, Intel, www.intel.com. So these are the manufacturers, and this is the web address of all these manufacturers. Selecting a motherboard, what to consider when buying a motherboard. Now I want to purchase a motherboard for, I can buy it for even my desktop or a laptop or for a server. Now what I have to consider when I am buying or when I am selecting the motherboard. First I need to check the form factor, then processor socket, then RAM, then PCI slots, then some of the features, and last is SATA. These are the factors that you have think once when you are buying your motherboard or when you are selecting motherboard for your computer system. Replacing our motherboard. Now, how can we replace the motherboard? I want to replace it with some other new advanced motherboard. How it is possible? First, disconnect all the cables, remove all the expansion cards from current motherboard. So if you want to replace your motherboard that is presently or currently in your computer system, if you want to remove it, first disconnect all the cables or all the expansion cards that is connected with your motherboard. Second, remove the screws that secure the old motherboard and remove the motherboard. First, disconnect, remove the cables, remove the cards, remove the screw, and remove the motherboard. If you are reusing the CPU and memory, remove them from the old motherboard and install them on the new one. If you want to use your old CPU and old memory, remove it from the old motherboard and install it on the new motherboard. Replace the old back panel IO template with the template supplied with the new motherboard. Now replace input output template. And here, install the new template that is supplied or that is provided with your new motherboard. This is how can we replace the motherboard. First, disconnect or remove all cables, remove all expansion cards, remove screws, then remove your motherboard. Now, it's your choice if you want to use your old CPU and memory, install this on the new motherboard and then replace your old back panel input output template with a new back panel input output template that is given with your new motherboard. Next, remove and install motherboard mounting ports as necessary to match the mounting holes on the new motherboard. Now remove your previous mounting post and install it with according to the new motherboard, but match the mounting holes. Install the new motherboard and screw and secure it with screw in all the mounting hole positions. It means now you just need to lock the nuts. Reinstall all of the expansion cards and reconnect the cable. Now your task is all the cables and expansion card that we disconnect in the step one. Now you just need to reinstall all the expansion cards and you just need to reinstall or reconnect all the cables on a new motherboard. Thank you so much, class.